KMC Inc. currently sells a single product. The contribution margin income statement for last year follows. Sales were $400,000, variable costs $280,000, contribution margin of $120,000, fixed cost $72,000, leaving net operating income of $48,000. Based on that information alone, we are to compute the break-even point in dollars. Now, as you know, we need to understand the cost structure, but in this problem, all we're given is total amounts for sales and variable costs. So we're going to have to use the contribution margin ratio to solve for the break-even point. The contribution margin ratio, of course, is the contribution margin of $120,000 divided by the sales of $400,000. That gives us a 30% contribution margin ratio. We can now solve for the break-even point. Notice that we're going to be computing our answer in sales dollars. When no per unit information is available, this is really your only option, is to solve for dollars of sales that you have to break even. And in our formula, in the numerator, you're going to have total fixed cost, $72,000, plus desired profit of zero, and you're going to divide by the contribution margin ratio of 30%. This tells us that at the break-even point, total sales dollars must be $240,000. I think it's important that you recognize when you have to use this method, and that of course is when we don't know the sales price per unit or the variable cost per unit. What this does is considers the relationship between sales and variable cost and contribution margin that should continue at all levels of activity. How much will profit increase if sales increase by $20,000? Assume there is no change in the cost structure. So what that means is that fixed cost will remain at $72,000 and the contribution margin ratio will be 30%. If that's true, we could recompute the income statement, but the easier way to find the increase in profit is to take the increase in sales of $20,000 and multiply by the contribution margin ratio of 30%. This will give us $6,000. So we know that if sales increase by $20,000, profit will increase by $6,000. Of course, the other $14,000 of sales will go toward covering variable costs. Okay, so this is how managers use the contribution margin ratio. So hopefully you can see why this is an important number for managers. So in this problem, we did review how to use the contribution margin ratio method for CVP analysis, and that is when no per unit information is provided. And we also learned a little bit about how to use the contribution margin ratio.